My lipstick looks so bad. My lipstick looks like I just put my lips in poop or mud. Maybe not poop, but mud for sure. B God, come on, go inside. That's what she said. Hi, you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. I don't know who would be new and watch an assumption tag if they don't know me, but anyway, still gonna introduce myself. Hi guys, I'm Kangsha. If my makeup looks rough, it's because it's been a lot of hours. It's been 7 hours that I put this on. It's almost what it is. It's 10 o'clock in the night, but I do have energy left. Just that my makeup might not look that good because it's been a long time I wore it. And also, this video I think will be already up. This is like the e.l.f. makeup tutorial, so I put this makeup on to, like, you know, do check-ins, so that's the reason it is still on. But anyways, if you haven't watched that video, click here and watch. I promoted also one video, yay. Anyways, finally sitting to do this assumptions video. I've been postponing this video since so long, I think over like 1.5 months or 2 months easily. Anyways, let's get started. So I asked you guys on Instagram a few assumptions about me, of course, so I'm going to answer all of your assumptions. My case is really pretty light, like I really like it. It has that glass finish, so it's like very glossy and looks nice. The only thing is it doesn't have the, what do you say, camera protection layer. If I put that, if I put like, if you can see that my camera is little top. Anyways, that is not the point. So the first assumption is that you are an early bird. No, I am not an early bird. These days, by these days, I mean since the past 3 to 4 months, I've been trying to wake up a little early. By early, I mean like 8:39. But I'm not really an early bird. The next assumption is that your parents were pretty chill for you choosing YouTube as your career when you did engineering. That is not true. They were not like easy. My mom did get convinced. My mom gets convinced very easily, but my dad was not convinced. I mean, I think both of them did believe, but it's all also like a security, you know, money security thing, career security thing, parents see. So it took me a little time to convince them, and I was very stubborn enough that meko, I want to do this, there's no other option than this. So they were like, I mean, if she's not gonna listen, what can we also say? And that's how they agreed. And the next assumption is that you don't wanna get married soon. That is very true. I don't wanna get married for another 5 years easily. I was 23, bro. Because my sister's marriage talks are going on in my house, they literally, like, they do mazak about me randomly. Out of anywhere, they just pull me in the thing and I get so annoyed. But anyway, that's just for fun. Next one is you're like kafi big wala introvert. That is very true. So I am a very, very big introvert to strangers. To my friends, I'm not. So you know, it really depends on the people. I don't like going out, meeting new people, socializing. That's not my thing. But when I'm like, you know, I would love to go out with my friends, go on trips with my friends. It's just that if I'm too much out, I just feel very drained, like around strangers. You are rich, 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 rich. So many rich. I am not rich. There's a lot of financial crisis we have had a long time, and I never had money. Like I've not born with a silver spoon or a golden spoon. We had to earn it. And even now, I would say, like, because I'm earning, I'm in a good position, I can buy what I want. But no, we are not rich. Sorry, I am not rich. Then you were a topper in your studies, and never. I was never a topper in my studies. I am like that above average, average kind of student, not really here, not really there. And that's, I mean, most of us are like that. Come on. The next one is you are a workaholic. I don't think I'm a workaholic. I do feel really guilty that I don't work enough. It could also be like maybe I'm not, I have like really high standards for myself. But according to me, I don't think I'm a workaholic. I do work. I mean, I kind of balance both the things well. Never thought blogging would be your career. Yes, I never thought blogging would be my career until 2 years ago. I always assumed I'll be just that person who does a job and like just goes on with their life and doesn't know what they want to do. But I guess, like, you know, 2 years ago, like when I started just discovering this world of Instagram, and like in the end of my third year engineering, I was like, you know, this is what I want to do, and I'm going to try and be better at this and see how it goes. So the next one is, everyone thinks you're an over attitude person, but you're sweet and straightforward. Am I right? That is actually very true. I am very straightforward and stern for people I don't know or I don't really like. It's like I can be a really cold person. Like my face can look really cold. I don't entertain people I don't like. It's not just in me. I need to like the person for that person to be around. If I don't like, it means I don't like. I cannot entertain them at all. And so that's the reason kind of people think I'm at like a little bit of attitude. And because I'm a little introvert, I don't talk a lot with strangers, and that also makes them think I have a lot of attitude. But once they know me, I mean, all my friends love me. So yeah. Next one is, you love your audience way too much. I do. I'm a Cancer, bro. I love like everything close to me. I'm very emotional. I'm very much attached to things which mean a lot to me. It means a lot to me. I really love. I'm not expressive as such in a lot of ways, but I do. I love my audience a lot. I get emotionally attached to a lot of things and I love it deeply. Then the next one is, you don't like to splurge a lot of money. Yes, I don't. I don't like to splurge money, but it happens. I don't like to do it. After I do it, I regret it. But these days, I'm trying to little control and not, spend a little bit, because I've got a lot of lectures now that I'm spending a lot of money. And I'm literally like, where's the money going? And I have to be like, everything I've got 2,000 only, 2,000, 3,000, 3,000, 2,000. And it's like gone, bro. I spent all my money. Anyways, next one is, you had braces on your teeth in your childhood. That's why your teeth are all set together. I don't think I hid it. I had braces even by like last year when I started blogging. I had them for 4-5 months of the initial months of after I started blogging. And if you go down on my Instagram, you'll find it. Even in my initial YouTube videos, I do have braces. Is on, so yes, that's true. So you are fulfilling your wishes now very quickly. I think yes, like the small things which I always wanted to buy and I never could, I'm earning now, so I do buy. Let be clothes, let be like, just to go out and eat. I couldn't do that before because I was on a budget, but now I do earn. I mean, now I feel bad to spend because it is my money, but yeah, I do buy what I want to, and I feel very grateful for it. And the next one is, you like to party a lot. So I'm not that person who actively like doesn't abhi peena hai jana hai type of thing. I don't drink a lot. It's just that I like the vibe. I'll sit around my friends and I chill, and I just enjoy looking at them and having fun. I do like get together, basically I just like being with my friends. Like not necessarily be a party. I mean, if all friends are together, I think it's kind of like a party, but yeah. Are you shy or do you feel awkward to talk in Telugu? This is false. I'm not shy to talk in Telugu. It's just that, there is one language. Everybody has this one language. See, I know Telugu very well. I know Hindi very well. I know English very well. But there's always one language which you're very comfortable in and is a common language you use when you want to express yourself or talk or something. And for that, it is English for me. For some other person, it might be Telugu. And for some other person, it might be Hindi. So for me, Telugu doesn't come out that way. So that's the reason, especially in front of camera, since I'm not used to talking in Telugu, I don't even know like how to talk, or maybe it's like a routine which I can develop. Like if I do more and more videos, I kind of can get comfortable talking in Telugu also. But at the moment, I'm just like, it sounds weird. It doesn't sound like me. That's the reason I don't like it. It kind of sounds too off. Like I don't feel like that's me who's talking. Anyway, the next assumption is that you are the mom friend. This is very true. I'm the mom friend in all my gangs, literally all my gangs. I am the mom friend. They call me mama, mommy, shut up, don't tell us so many things. So yeah, I'm the mom friend in all my allies. You are a bisexual or bi-curious woman? No, I've never heard the word bi-curious. I'm sorry, like it's just something I'm hearing for the first time, so I'm assuming it is bisexual. But no, I'm not. This is false. I'm a cisgender woman. The next one is, you earn more than 10k monthly from social media. I earn good enough money, not 10k. If I was only earning 10k, my dad would like kick me and make me go for a job. I don't just earn 10k, I earn more than that. The next assumption is, you don't fall for boys that easily. That is very true. It is not only for love, it is for friendship, it is for anything. Boys, I feel, a lot of boys in college, it could be something else, but I've been told also sometimes that boys are kind of little intimidated by me. I don't know why. I mean, I don't entertain that easily. Like I've told you before, like if I don't know them, I don't entertain them as much. And somebody has to be the, what do you say, icebreaker. And post that I can be, but until then, I'm like very stiff and stern until I know them and like them. I'm like, ah, okay, so what's your point kind of person. So yeah, kind of, yeah, I don't fall for boys. I don't fall for anyone easily. You know what happened with the next one is that you stand up for what is right even if you know the whole world will turn against you. I don't know why I have this confidence in me that I have the power. I mean see, there's always going to be someone who's like against my opinions, obviously, but if you give me people who are open to discussion and open to change, I can convince them for what's right. So I, because I feel like I put down my points very well on like when like I love having like deep meaningful conversations, and in those things I feel like I really have good points when I talk about such things. So yeah, I think like if need be, and if you know there's something wrong, I will stand up for what is right. I mean, all of us have our own battles to pick. Everybody cannot talk about like all the issues going on in this world because it's physically not possible, and it's not something, you know, anybody can do. So I think people need to actually, you know, give space for people to pick their own fights, pick their own battles, and then work on that. And the next one is that you were a tomboy kind of girl in school or college. Yes and no. I mean, I was not really much into makeup and like etc. I didn't know this world, first of all, and I didn't like, you know, have any knowledge about dressing or anything. I think post that, it's basically, it was like lack of knowledge. I was not like tomboy, but I didn't even dress up. So yeah, it was like, you know, in between. I don't really have an answer for that. One is that you don't care about sponsorships that much and only take the ones you really like. That is actually very true. I mean, the amount of collabs I decline is a lot, but yeah, that is how it's been. Last year, even when I was not earning much because I could like stay in my house and I didn't have any bills to pay because my dad took care, I didn't like even take brand deals even when I had like very small following. But now I think a touch wood that I kind of get you know, deals I really like as well. So you know, I pick them, and the rest of the things I'm just like, nah. Next assumption is, I thought you were 18-19 years at the beginning when I started following you at first. Me, 18-19, I think that is one of the best compliments I got, because I look a lot older, and I was always found like, I mean, people always thought I was like a lot older than I was, like 3-4 years elder than what I was. Even in my 10th, people thought I was in engineering, people thought I was in a job. So yeah, I always look older. So this was like a very big surprise that you thought I was 89. No, I'm 23 years old. Next one, assumption is lazy girl. That is very true. I'm a very lazy girl. I'm trying to change that, trying to be more productive. But until now, yes, yeah, I am a lazy girl. Next one is, you're a very pampered child. False. I am not pampered at all. Except for like few things my mom does for me, which are very sweet. Other than that, I'm not pampered. We've been taught to fought our own battles, do everything, and I'm very grateful for that, because had I that not been the scene, I mean, I don't think I would have been what I am today. So I'm like kind of glad I was not very pampered. You don't have a lot of friends because the previous ones let you down. So I really didn't have friends until I like, you know, got into 11th standard. All the friends I had in school were just like, you know, there, like not really close and stuff. So I kind of grew up by 11th, and later I started getting very picky with friends. Maybe because I never had a lot of friends, I like got close to only few people who I really felt connected with. So yeah, I like then, you know, after that I don't become like friends with some people. Like if I have to be like really close friends, then I need to really connect with that person, and I just connect with very few like that. So that's the reason I have like very like small circle. Even in Pune, like I have like 5 friends who I'm really close to, but all 5 of them have different gangs. But I didn't have like that. I just had those 5 people, and if they all had plans, I should just like sit and see like what do I do. They used to of course call me with them, ki, you know, let's go, but I don't like, you know, just like going out with so many people who I'm not even really close to or comfortable with. So I should like, you know, like it's never mind, you just go and come. So that's false. Nobody has let me down except for like once I had a fight with somebody who I was really close to. But yeah, nobody let me down. It's just that I am like generally a little picky when I make friends. I don't like get friends with anybody very randomly. And the next one is, you're judged by your relatives on a daily basis. This, I think I've moved past the phase where I even care about what any of my relatives say, or and they also know that, so I don't think they say anything. At least they don't say it to my face or to my parents. I've not heard something like that. But yeah, all relatives talk. I really don't care. I'm working hard, paying my bills, doing what I love. So it really doesn't have to matter. But you know, they have to bother about everything. Like, they can take care of their old children, right? I mean, the next two assumptions are, you're very hairy. That is very true. I'm a very hairy person. And the other one is, neutral shades lover. No, I am not. I love myself some colors. I am a very colorful person. I run away from nudes. It's just too boring for me. I mean, after I like it, I like the aesthetic of it. When I see something like that, I would be like, it is really nice, but it's just something not for me. If I have to pick, you know, neutrals, I don't think I would like, you know, pick neutrals. Next one is, most of the people you come across always assume that you're mean. That is very true. The next one is, you're not a fan of budget-friendly makeup brands. This is so false. I use so many drugstore products. This is very much false. I use a lot of drugstore products. The next one is, you're really rich. You have a BMW and your parents are pretty chill. No, I'm not rich. No, I don't have a BMW. But yeah, my parents are pretty chill. My parents are chill about everything except boys. Like, if I have guy friends or anything like that, they get so annoyed. But they're pretty chill for the other thing. But I think that is the kind of main thing we want. So yeah, anyways, with that, I think I'll end this video. I've been talking for 34 minutes already. I'm not sure how long this video is going to be now. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this fun little assumption video. I know I'm quite late in this game, but I'm really sorry. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel so that you can see more of this face and enjoys. But yeah, that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one.